Hello everyone. Welcome to the 31st video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, you will learn the following. How to add effects to footage. Bilateral blur effect. Camera lens blur effect. Replacing footage and transferring effects to new footage. Camera shake Deblur effect. CC cross blur effect. CC radial blur effect. CC radial fast blur effect. To add an effect to a layer, first, select the desired layer in the timeline. Go to the effects and presets panel and double-click on the desired effect. You can also call the effects from the search section. Another way to choose effects is to go to the effects menu. First, select the timeline panel and the desired layer and click on the desired effect from the effects menu. I choose the bilateral blur effect from blur and sharpen group. The bilateral blur effect selectively blurs an image to preserve edges and other details. Areas of high contrast are less blurred than areas of low contrast. In the settings of this effect, by increasing the value of the radius, more pixels are gathered together to determine the blur, so increasing the value of the radius also increases the blur. Also, by changing the value of the threshold, the amount of blur also changes. By clicking on FX, I activate and deactivate the effect. When colorize is not selected, the footage will be displayed in black and white. Note that all options of effects that have this stopwatch icon can be animated. For example, I click on both the radius and threshold stopwatches to change the stopwatch's color to blue. Now I select the layer and press U to see all the keyframes. I put the time indicator in frame 1 and set the value of the radius and threshold to 0. I move the time indicator back to frame 0 and hit the space button to play. In this way, you can see that the amount of blur gradually decreases. I select this effect and press the delete button. Now I select the camera lens blur effect. The camera lens blur effect simulates blurring and drawing attention to the subject in the camera. In the settings of each effect, there is a reset option that allows you to return the effect settings to the default state. By increasing the blur radius value, the amount of video blur will increase. By changing the shape option, the shape of blur changes in the footage. Pay attention to the lines to see how they affect the footage. You can also see their effect in the footage by changing the amount of rotation, aspect ratio and round knees. I press the reset button to return the effect to the default. I slightly increase the blur radius value. Now, to draw attention to a subject, we can blur only a part of the image. To do this, I first deselect the layer. I select the shape and rectangle tools and then select the radial gradient mode. I select white and black in the gradient editor and click OK. Now, holding down the control button, I double-click on the shape tool. I increase the color radius of the black color. In this way, I want the footage to be blurred only in the areas where there is white color. Now I move the shape layer down. I select the footage layer and then in the blur map section, I select the shape layer. You can see in this picture that it is blurred only in the areas that we created for the white color shape. By selecting the effect option, the effects applied to the shape will be added to the footage. To change the blur radius, I click on the rectangle option and drag this handle. Now I select this footage layer and go back to the project panel. By holding the Alt button and dragging, I replace this footage with the previous footage. In this way, you can see that all the effects are transferred to the new footage. I return to the Effect Controls panel. Also, the Repeat Edge Pixels option is active to correct the edges of the footage. And the option of Use Linear Working is used to create the prominence of blurred lines. I adjust the focal distance blur amount. Activating the Invert Blur Map option will invert the map. I delete the shape and effect layer and select the Camera Shake Deblur effect from the Effects menu. Camera Shake Deblur effect helps you to recover blurry images caused by camera shake. This effect targets blur frames and tries to recreate them by using sharps on both sides of the blur frame. Blur duration changes the number of frames to compare around frames that are blurred to get a frame without blur. For high vibration duration, choose a high value for this feature, and vice versa. Pay attention, because now our footage does not have vibration, it does not create a change effect. I choose the standard Deblur method. The strength option controls the amount of correction made to the blur frame. Also, adjust the value of shake sensitivity to determine how much blur is needed to completely fade. I also delete this effect and select the CC cross blur effect. The CC cross blur effect creates blur in X and Y directions. Also, by activating the repeat edge pixels option, we can fix the missing edges of the video. With the transfer mode option, we can change the type of blur transfer. I also delete this effect and select the CC radial blur effect. The radial blur effect creates a blur around a point and simulates zooming or rotating the camera. In the settings of this effect, we can set the type of blur, amount, and quality. We can also adjust the location of the center point of the effect. I also delete this effect and select the CC Radial Fast Blur effect. The CC Radial Fast Blur effect creates a zoom and blur mode from the central point. In the settings of this effect, it is possible to change the center point of the effect and the amount of blurring. Also, we can change the type of zoom, which creates a state of prominence in the footage. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. In the next video, I will teach you the continuation of the effects. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.